own, but you really need the team around it. And I think with the way that the team have drafted, they definitely want to have this.
Forward, Envy's up here on the high ground. He's popped everything. Going to look for that stomp with the Centaur. Micro's not the best. Envy gets locked down, and he is just going to be killed off instantly. Na'Vi arrive, and they arrive in force. The Tombstone is helping out a little bit, but IX Mike, only level 5. Just trying to buy a little bit of time as Gunner comes over, gets into position. Nusha with the Echo Slam catches 3. Oh my word, Na'Vi were too grouped up. Crystallize does have the Shrine here. He's going for the Centaur, but Envy's actually just kind of baiting him a little bit. And once again, Crystallize, no TP. Team completely surrounding him. And this is going to be yet another kill for them, it looks like. He's got the spin back off cooldown soon. He's pretty fast, but Nusham's got the blink.
Yeah, Mineski are looking to finish this game off now. Refractions there for TA. I think that we just saw a creep get cold, and that's they jump in a really big call, but the save comes. One Moon dunk is going to be there. Dunk is down. Is it another
two
one?
Dunks.
Find himself another dunk. Moon is still living through this, but not for that much longer.
Pop goes to TA.
And is going to drop. So a triple kill for Ghostick.
Was in before.
Yeah, they knocked out JStorm first. It was against Forward.
Hook shot in. Looks like they've locked down Gunner. That's going to be a really big kill if they can get it. Cuckoo's going to get traded out here. Oh no,
oh, he's just
Armel, he just can't do enough damage. That mech build looks like it's going to keep him alive. Tims, what an initiation, but the disruption from IX Spike managed to save Gunner alive still. AU comes in, tries
double
to
stun again,
out, but no, they do finally manage to bring down Gunner, but it's going to be almost a total wipe here. Gabby, he's going to try and get one more kill before he dies, but he can't even get that.
Smoking up now. Heading outside of the base, this is a dangerous high ground. Crystallize's smoke has already been broken. Cuckoo breaks everything with his invis, and Tims splits them up. Magical's on the high ground, but the rest of the team trapped in the low ground. He's going to try and survive with the Shrine until his team can get back up here. They drop the Serpent Wards down, but they're on the low ground. It's not really doing that much, and now Gabby finds his opportunity to charge into the back lines. Choose dead. Misha also going to be brought down. Triple kill for Armel. How many more can he get? Lasso now onto Crystallize. Won't quite be a Rampage. AU
push alive. Are going to sentry out the trap, but they've got to be careful here. The toss
this
back.
It's going to be questionable. They are going to be able to get the instant toss into Hex and straight up blow him up. But can they actually survive through the second? Like, Fairy Spirit's going to go down. So now going to be a 4v5. Yeah, never mind. KP, he's going to die in the northern side. Iceberg doesn't actually have the fraction up. What a black hole for Febby. Actually managed to lock down 3 with the LS.
Makes up for everything.
There is so much damage with the 3-man impel as well from Ninja Boogie. What a combo from Mineski. That's going to be able to wipe out Ghostick, the Weaver. He's not making it out alive.
Around it or outplay it. Just letting them get away with everything under the sun isn't good for you either. They're gonna pop the ult.
Na'Vi, they've gotta take a fight. They're gonna blow up Kaka almost right away. They do manage to get him. The Winter's Curse is gonna be able to slow down both the Tide as well as the OD. Managed to get the double silence on them. Yi now turns though. On Magical is gonna be able to get away with those refractions. Both the left is closing down with Gush. The Ravage is gonna go down. Managed to finish off the Wyvern. Lockdown Magical. Log it up. No, actually, Magical is gonna have the refraction. That means the OD is gonna die. Traded out for Magical. Old 11 trying to stop Crystallize, but he's just gonna get run down underneath the trees now. Old Chicken, he's trying to make it out as well, but Crystallize
nice
nails
staff,
him with a
nice stun.
He's got the Iron Shell as well to be able to burn down not just this core, but the two supports.
So the buyback from Kaka.
Kaka came back for this. It's going to be dieback for him.
Give it to him.
Ultra
give it to him.
Crystallize and give him the Rampage.
Give it to
baby.
Him.
Na'Vi had been litting keen.
He's got a Hurricane Pike now too. This is just going to be another good item against the Ursa, who doesn't have the potential to jump in with the blink. They're going to make the
They're
jump.
They're going to blow him up as quick as possible. They will be able to take away that Aegis, but maybe they overcommitted because a beautiful ice path from AU locks them down, slows them all. Cuckoo jumps in, does manage to get the Doom off of the Darkseer. So that Teamfighter and Og, another ice path. It was 2 before. It's 3 this time. There's no doubt.
Terrorblade there to be able to follow up on it, though.
I don't know.
Do you just have to wait until the Aegis fades and then try and kill the Jug right as that happens?
I don't know. They might be looking to go on to someone like...
Oh, no. Limp just a little bit too far forward. He's going to get doomed. He gets rooted and he gets stunned up. He's gone. Iceberg beyond godlike. They are jumping into the back lines. They're looking for Ghostick. Can they bring him down? Nice Earth Splitter coming through, but Miracle tanking up a lot of damage. Omni Slash bouncing around. They do end up losing the Doom. Ghostick also falling. Buyback from Limp, but he's getting spun down, and that's a dieback for him. Beyond godlike for Iceberg as he looks for more kills, but a nice blink in from Death. He keeps getting those sticky stacks up, but Naive is just too strong at this point in the game. Able to keep on charging forward. They get another Shackle onto 343. Miracle trying to fight, but looks like he's only going to end up getting through the Aegis and will lose his life. Ultra kill for Iceberg. Can he get this Rampage?
Give him the Rampage.
Come on, Death. Iceberg looking to close it out. Buyback as well from Z Freak. They give him the Rampage.
Spike. They need to hit hard and fast. Get a kill and move on to the next. Cuckoo is going to present himself for Eternal Envy. Oh, he doesn't get the blink off, but the Hex! Armel got off in time and the Yakko Slam hits so hard! Team, they are slammed into oblivion! Gabby will have the triple kill, a blink away for Gunner. He's done so much, but he cannot do any more. He's on the run. He'll blink once more, but into the mid, you're looking for the push. Maybe they can find the kill. Yeah, they're going to chase him to the end of the earth. You'll set the rub. The perfect gust timing, an ultra kill for Gabby. Here we go. This is going to be the moment. If they can find an opportunity, Rubick, he's waiting on the cliff. They see, they pick him up. Gunner, he dies so quickly. The nightmare save from Ice Spike 88. It won't be a great Omni Slash. One is stolen. He's pulling it back into Tim. That's Ravage. He's pushing forward. The Sun's on the Eternal Envy. He cannot die. New Shove hits the black hole. Three caught, but then run! Catching three of his own. There goes Team down the drain.
There's no ultimates up on the side of Team. I don't think. Yeah, they're paying it. It's skill time, boys.
Don't delay, boys. Don't delay. Move through. There goes your melee racks. Cougar's like, hey, boys, I think I know how we can win this game of Dota 2. I think I know how we can knock Team out of ESL 1 Mumbai. You hit the tier 4 towers. You play the objective based gaming. You take the dire ancient. Where is any kind of abilities? There's no Ravage. They move forward. Oh! There! Oh! Four of them together! Stylish! TNC!
So, Panko, at least they tried to take advantage of the fact that two heroes, two cores, were missing from that Roshan pit. Trying to go back in. There is going to be the Cole and the Brace for South. The Enrage is going to go down before the stun is hit. Nice Ice Path. Greater Macro Pyre too, but now with no longer having Enrage and no longer having the Alchemist either, they're just lacking in damage entirely. The Winter's Curse just laid out into the Tiny to make sure he can't escape, but the Ursa is so fast. Look at him. He knows the Blink Dagger is coming up. He tries to juke him out, and he just did it. Oh, the 11.
Medusa at the moment, but they're actually hoping to jump them from the side, get into the back lines, find the sniper, find everybody else. They're gonna go for it. They go for Chu first, looking to focus him down. Auto attacks from the low ground. Ajit does find the killing spree, but they are gonna lose Moon in the process potentially. They try to defensively swap him out, but Na'Vi slapping Mineski back, pushing him outside of their base. Magical maybe needing to be a little bit careful. Ajit is coming running towards him. Ninja Boogie is gonna put his life on the line just to try and get the Dusa in a good position to kill the sniper, but it's not gonna work. He gets pushed back by the Keeper of the Light, and now they've got the lockdown onto Ajit. He's isolated from the team. Mana Shield's not going to do anything for him as he gets shackled up. They bring him down, and Na'Vi take a 4-for-1. Still chasing for a little bit more. KP getting bashed, actually, as everyone else is closing the gap. Also slowed down. Another bash, another swashbuckle. Can they get the full team wipe? Crystallize almost here, and they don't even need him.
Already, if she hits that 25, maybe everyone gets speed or get the spell block. Nyx Assassin stunned up, pushed in. That 4-star, he's so exposed. A secondary 4-star with the Sonic Wave. Everyone gets pushed back, and then you bring in the Spectre. Right on top, Armel's losing life way too fast. The Ice Pass will create a little bit of space. Maybe for Cuckoo to TP up, and no! Kaka hits the double stun.
And you just don't need anything now. Go ahead.
It's a little bit further to the south. That's why that Sentry Ward didn't detect it. Batrider already with three stacks on that Jingu Mastery. The Doom is on the Monkey King. He cannot get that Wukong. He actually doesn't even have it anyway. GA protecting. No physical damage can kick in. Cuckoo is trying to find that last bit of burn. They'll have to drop the Storm, but Armel moves through it. They really want this kill on the Monkey King, and they won't get it. Doom will time out in 1 second, and the curse creates even more space. Cuckoo just has to sit here and wait for four heroes to murder him as he wakes up to the nightmare that is this game. Maybe they have not done enough damage just yet. Cuckoo is still surviving. They'll have to wall him up and commit a little bit more. What goes on? It's the curse. They turn it onto the Omni Knight. They can't repel that damage, and Cuckoo can TP away! He is home! Old 11 is injured, and Gabby wants to come back in. They'll turn on the reflection. How much damage can they do? A three-man ice path. That's where they hit it. Omni Knight's already gone down. TNC trying to turn it around. Old Chicken so low. He's burning at the moment. He's trying to get a slap down to get a little bit more life. What's stolen is the Jingu. Slap him back. The tree looks for the dodge, but it's still cannot stop TNC.
Keen Gaming, maybe that'll change the nature of these team fights, because it seems like the PA struggled to be able to go on any of these cores. But the roll-in, Blitzy's already set this up. They had the vision, and now even on top of the shrine, it doesn't seem to matter. It's Na'Vi and Lockdown Kaka. They're actually not getting a ton of damage on the cores just yet, but that's because the BKBs have already been popped. The support for support with the buyback coming in for the Winter Wyvern. Already the Pango's been locked down. Winter's Curse on the Storm Turret as well, with the Amplified damage on him, and an Ice Path as well. That is beautifully set up by Keen Gaming. Another crush from Old 11. Blizzy gets a lot of damage after the swashbuck.
jungle. Crystallize is trying to capitalize on that as best as possible. Oh, chicken, wham! 1200 damage on that disruptor. That is the extra Midas armor doing some work for you. The crush comes in, and they can just turn onto this Spectre Crystallize. Or maybe he can actually battle out with the radius damage over time. Ultigan's trying to get away, and he does manage to get out, killing the Spectre and getting away.
But instead, I mean, now he's got almost 50% lifesteal. He's going to be hexed up immediately here. Spectre's going to pop his ultimate. They're going to get the lockdown, but the Cold Embrace is going. Look at that. Magical immediately finds the Winter Wyvern. Like always, that's the thanks of the Spectre, but he doesn't actually kill him in time. And now they're going to have the Winter's Curse. The Spectre not really laying that much damage. It's only into an illusion. Old 11 trying to get that bash onto Magical. Does manage to get one, but he's still too tanky. Another big swashbuckle hit is going to be able to silence up the Ember Spirit. He's dead. Here comes the buybacks. They need to be able to finish off Magical. They do manage to do so. Locking down another one. They're going to be able to try and go for Crystallize up next. Crystallize, that disarm on so many heroes.
They know
Stormfury's almost here! They got a bash on him and a crit!
He's gone!
What happened? He disappeared! Getting so much information, but Keen already have an Observer and
they
Sentry. So if the smoke breaks and now the hits, who do you go on? The Fissure does connect over on two. Tidehunter is number one. They're going for the big man to begin with. This is a hard ask. The creeps are coming up through the rear as well. As the rock wall dissipates, Moon, he's battling in the tree lines so they can catch Karkar out. Once again, as well as the Lich, they go for the supports, but now, can they get the bigger ones? Can they kill off a core into Old 11 with a Requiem of Souls? Razor, well, he won't do that much damage. The TP's are coming out. KP comes up for double kill, but does he have any more friends? When the Yorsim sends Moon up in the air, he's got no other choice but to stand here and fight against a 280 plus damage Razor, who is in the trees. Has he got enough? Moon working with Arjit. Khaehan's just working through KP. How much damage have you got? Enough to finally bring down the biggest raid boss of all, a Ninja Boogie with the Cold Embrace. KP gets a little bit more life, and Keen Gaming, they have to kill him again through the Aegis the Immortal. Hold him, and kill him! Such a great ability is Lashraka. He just ripped through the tier 3 tower. Maneski has to kill this pony.
But the in and out just continuously.
They got stung again. If they want to hold him in position, everyone's together. Febby's getting stunned up, just Chainstun while Ember Spirit locked in by Moon. He may have enough damage to get through all chicken. The damage negation is there, but finally they burn through the Ember. He'll buy back and jump into the spirit. The BKB just wore off. Mirana, she's got no more leaps available. She's stranded over on the far side while Monkey King will die inside of his own Wukong command. They'll finally kill off the Lashrak. Yes, they do, but buybacks need to be committed. Monkey's dead for 2 minutes' time. So is the ES. So is the Wyvern.
Way, but so far, Keen is
really want
so smooth.
Like, TA is so isolated here. Maybe they can get it. Remember, Global Silence is down, so Black Hole will be useful, but that Sleight of Fist does some work. They break the Aegis Immortal, and now here we go for the fight. The Black Hole instantly. Templar Assassin held in position and brought down the Darkseer Wall, however. It'll help him fight backwards with the fact pulling Monkey King a little bit closer. He needs more distance, but the next Assassin Impel connects, and with the silences, they just can't do anything, Maneski, apart from +2, +2, +2 = 6. KP felt it, however. He'll jump away. I think it's almost that time to TP away to safety, but Spirit jump up and down. Old Chicken found him over in the trees. It's a black hole, but it will do nothing. There is no follow-up. It's another +2 for the silencer, and that may just be the game. It is. GG is called. Maneski put all their hopes in the black hole. They could never get it off because Keen are just way too good.
The community has spoken, and the MVP is...